Dutch Sense here. 12:32 p.m. Central Time on Saturday, February 25th, 2012. And we're looking at IntelliCast here. If the continental radar view turned on, plus Titan storm tracking, we'll go ahead and turn on the National Weather Service alerts as well. Right now there's no severe alerts issued, but let's turn on the winter warnings and see if anything else is issued. Northeast still under winter weather watch. Also the Northwest and the North Midwest under a winter weather advisory. So be aware if you're traveling in these areas, guys, there'll be some blowing snow. It doesn't look like blizzards or anything, but it will be hard to travel through those areas. But as you get down here into South Texas, look right over the Gulf of Mexico, heading up over Houston, heading towards New Orleans and Baton Rouge, Louisiana, we have another strong line of cells breaking out that's going to come up over the south here. And that'll take a few hours, obviously, for it to happen. But once it gets up over here over Mississippi, Alabama, and Georgia, and the north part of Florida, we may see additional severe weather, maybe even into central Louisiana and Texas. It'll all depend on how big this system ends up turning out to be. Now, to see the size of it, let's go ahead and turn on the cloud cover. Okay, and you can see it's actually beginning to form that left-hand hook of a common low pressure system, but I don't think that will have the time to form. It's going to get pulled up over here within the next day to the northeast, and when that happens, of course, it'll go out to sea and most likely will not become that large low pressure system. Now up here to the northwest, we have additional line of storms coming on shore, and to see that better, let me turn the radar back on. Okay, it's extending anywhere from North Dakota all the way through Washington State on that new track that the storms are taking based upon the new location of the North Pole. And I could go into that, but I'm going to just go ahead and put a link down below. You guys can go watch the previous videos I've made showing this new location of the North Pole in Siberia, Russia. And that's moved everything to the northwest, which has moved the warmer latitudes also to the north and northwest. Now, one final thing, folks. I do want to tell you, for the last day now, I went and got HD gear and sound gear. I did it last weekend too. I'm working on the WeatherMod documentary, and it should hopefully be done by the end of spring. All right, that's my target finish date for this. It should be roughly an hour and a half long, with interviews of a few different prominent people, meteorologists, two military people and a scientist, and also a few interviews of normal people, YouTube video makers, entertainer, and just average people on the street, and then a full explanation from me of every discovery that I've made, every PDF that I've found, and a full breakdown of what I've discovered. And put all that together with the interviews and shots of the areas, and you're going to get a great WeatherMod documentary, guys. Again, hopefully it should be done by late spring. At the latest, it'll be probably June-ish, something like that, maybe first part of summer. But I'm hoping to have it done by that tornado season time where everybody's interest is peaked, and that's where we can really begin to discuss it. So hang in there, folks, and I want to thank all my viewers for helping me get this done. Obviously, this stuff is expensive. It's like $1,200 a day to rent the gear, and that's for the high-end stuff. I'm going for the mid-range. The low-end is not what I need, so I really appreciate you guys helping. I've put my whole paycheck into this. For those of you who don't know, I'm still doing carpenter's apprentice job, all right? So I'm putting everything I can into it. My wife is helping out too, and the viewers are making up the difference. So you guys will all get your first name and last initial put into the WeatherMod documentary at the end, everybody who donated. I don't want to obviously put in your full name. If you want your full name in there, you can contact me and let me know if you've donated, and I'll put it in there. But otherwise, it'll be first name, last initial, and amount donated, and it'll all come up in the credits. So thank you so much. And if you live in the South, be aware, severe weather may break out here anytime now once this gets over land. As it passes up over Houston and over Louisiana, this is the area you'd like to watch. Again, let's turn on the severe weather alerts, see if the National Weather Service is giving any kind of forewarning for this. And no, there's not. There's no actual warnings issued. So we'll have to watch and wait and see. Cheers, folks.